Moving back to the station area, this blank bit here, we're going to have was it a big signal box or a power box. It's going to go in on that section there. So the line you see here, which is connected to the main line over the back there, you can see the crossover. So it links the outer main line to this, which is the, as I say, the branch line, which links the upper level to the lower level. So that's fitted on some Woodland Scenics subterranean inclines. This is the steepest one that they do. I think it's something like about 4% grade. I know some of you ask, these are only about a couple foot sections, and it's about 8 foot, so in length. Some locos need to be banked to get up it, but because of space constraints I've got up here, it's the only thing I could do. I just didn't have the space really to put a bigger, not so steep incline in. So anyway, this links down to the lower level. See here, basically hits two sets of points. This point here basically is the start of the return loop to the trains, as many of you have seen before, run round across the Holme Grand Suspension Bridge. That's been modified slightly and sits on two pieces of trunking or ducting that are used for tumble dryers, and they're about a metre height off the floor, so there's enough for me to duck underneath there. So once the train's crossed the bridge, it's a Y point. There's two options. One, to either run back round, so it's like a lower running loop, or it runs round that side and the reversing loop and comes back round back to here. Then I can send the trains back up the up ramp, so it looks as though they've been out somewhere and come back. Failing that, I can send them round into the storage loops, which I've got underneath the main station area, by sending round on this route here. The Pendolino, you can see sat at the back there, that's on the outer test track loop, which is connected by two crossovers, one there and one either side just over there, and that's dual powered, so I can either run off the Hornby Elite DCC controller or just a standard analog controller. Where the Pendolino driving trailer sat there, that's just another storage siding, so I can run with the right single card DMUs in there. So on this side here of that storage side in there, we have the reverse loop module for operating trains around the reverse loop. So as you can see here, as we move around, we have the other crossover that links the outer test track loop round to this line here, which is linked to the return loop, and this line feeds basically the lower level storage loops, and this is basically four tracks, or five if you include the test track loop for the storage sidings, and these will take the full length 9 car Pendolino and 11 car a push. On the outer test track loop, full length Pendolino, no problem. The line you can see there, as I pointed out before, that's basically just part of the lower loop that we've got if we want to run trains continuously round over the suspension bridge. So from the bridge, just over there, so you can see where the line runs round and joins onto the storage loop here. And this is basically the other end of the lower level storage loop, so for the yard, whatever you want to call it. And then runs back around behind the back of the ramp there. And again, that's the outer test track loop there. So freezer maintenance, that baseboard there, the two baseboards that are there, this one here, and these two here are all removable, so I can gain access to the lower level, and also if I need to do anything with the wiring on these upper sections. Again, I've still got to get around to soldering the rails to the copper clad sleepers on this section there, and then we'll finish off the ballasting on that bit there. Once we've got all the ballasting done, I'll just do a little bit more test running, and then it's a case of we'll be fitting overhead catenary. Now we've got a load of the Hornby catenary. It's a crude, but it works, but I'm thinking of maybe going for something a bit more realistic. So I'm more than likely possibly be looking at selling the Hornby overhead catenary. If anybody is possibly interested, drop us a message, and if I do think ahead of and selling the Hornby catenary, I'll let you know. Going back to what's going to be the container depot over there, we'll have one of the buildings in the pallet boxes I've got underneath the layout, zoom marked to go over there, is this. It's basically one of the Hornby Scaledale buildings. It was a limited edition, and each one obviously come with a certificate, and it was limited to 500, and this is number 73. They do come up from time to time, just keep your eye on eBay or the toy and train fairs, you might be able to snap one up. Yeah, it was released a few years ago, so let's say this Eddie Stobart building, we're going to put by the container depot. I've got a number of 176 scale Stobart trucks that we're going to put in front of it. If one of you asks, no, I'm not selling it, so don't bother asking. Anyway, that in the nutshell then is basically a quick tour, but I've tried to keep it brief as possible, of what the layout is, and obviously there's going to be more updates to come as we progress further once we've got the ballasting done and moving on with the Scenics. So stay tuned, more to come. Thanks for watching.